Hi, and welcome back to my newest video about what is a backlog and why is backlog management so important when we are doing agile software development. Let's have a look. A backlog, in its simplest form, is just an ordered list of open work. On top, we have the most refined items, and at the bottom, we have the undefined items. There are two types of backlogs, which is the product backlog and the sprint backlog. Of course, if you are doing scaled agility, then you will also have the portfolio backlog, which we will not discuss in this video, but in a later video. The product backlog is an ordered list of open work for a specific product. On top, we have all the refined items, and on the bottom, we have the less refined or not yet refined items. A product backlog consists of product backlog items. And as said, they are all ordered. They are on the top estimated, and the product owner takes care, together with the team, about these product backlog items. Such a product backlog is always transparent and publicly available. As already said, the product owner prioritizes the product backlog items, and he has also the final saying about the priority in such a product backlog. Because a product evolves, a product backlog is never complete and it evolves over time. If you want to know more about the role of the product owner, then I have already made a video right up here for you. A sprint backlog is just a selection of product backlog items which are going into a sprint. This sprint backlog is nothing else than a plan of the development team to deliver these product backlog items. And this sprint backlog is completely owned by the development team. And only the development team can change the sprint backlog during a sprint. I already can hear the whining and crying of the wannabe product owners out there, which are basically nothing else than project managers. Yes, it's true. If you want to be truly agile, then the development team needs to own the sprint backlog, and only they can change it together with you as a product owner if it's needed. But the sprint backlog is a plan of the development team to deliver these selected product backlog items, which has been prioritized by the product owner. When we look at the sprint backlog, then such a sprint backlog is just a simple to-do list. Of course, you can do it as complicated as you like, but in general, in the simplistic form, it has three columns: the to-do, the doing, and the done column. If you want to know more about the role of the development team, then I have created a video for you. Of course, there are many tools out there which allow you to do the backlog management. Here you can see the periodic table of DevOps tools, and the tools for simple backlog management for single teams are these tools down here. Here we see an example backlog out of Jira, where you can see down here the product backlog and up here the sprint backlog with the items already assigned out of the product backlog into the sprint backlog. And here you can see also the button to start a new sprint. When you have started a new sprint in Jira, then you are on the sprint backlog, which you can see here. Again, this is the most simple sprint backlog we can have. It has the items of to do, in progress, and done. And with this example, we are at the end of this video. I will create now some more videos about the product backlog items, about non-function requirements, definition of ready, definition of done, and how we can scale the whole backlog management. So please don't forget to subscribe to this channel and give me a thumbs up if you liked this video.